Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another linear approximation problem today. This one is asking us to find the equation of the tangent line, and it was submitted by one of our viewers. The function that's given, or the equation I should say that's given, is e to the xy plus x squared minus y squared equals 5. And they ask us to find the equation of the tangent plane at the point, or sorry, at the tangent line at the point 2, 0. Okay, so when we're dealing with linear approximation, when we're asked to find the tangent line or the tangent plane, when we have two variables, as we do here with x and y, normally, if we're finding the tangent line and there's one variable, we just take the derivative and then do some work. In this case, since we have two variables, we have to take partial derivatives. So we'll first need to take partial derivatives with respect to x and y. Actually, before I do that, let me go ahead and write out the linear approximation equation, the equation that we're going to use, or the formula that we're going to use to build our equation of the tangent line. It looks like this. Z minus z1 equals a times x minus x1 plus b times y minus y1. When you're dealing with two variables, as we are here, x and y, this is always the equation that you want to use to find the equation of the tangent plane or the tangent line. So each of these components is represented by something we're going to solve for. You're going to end up leaving z, x, and y intact, and we're going to be solving for z1, x1, and y1, as well as a and b, and I'll let you know what each of those represent as we go through. So, like I said, first thing we do, partial derivatives with respect to x and y. So, first, the partial derivative with respect to x. We go term by term. So, partial derivative with respect to x of e to the xy. Remember, when we're taking partial derivatives, we're holding the opposite variable constant. So, in this case, since we're taking it with respect to x, we're treating y as a constant. So, I like to think of it as the number 2, or the number 3, a constant. So, if y is 3, then this term here, instead of e to the xy, ends up looking like e to the 3x, right? Because that, if we replace that with 3, it would become the coefficient on this x term, and we'd have e to the 3x. Well, the derivative of e to the 3x, right, is 3e to the 3x. Well, in this case, what does 3 represent? It represents y. So it's not 3e to the 3x, it's ye to the yx. In that case, we would reorganize those variables. You always want to have your variables in alphabetical order. So instead of 3e to the 3x, it would be ye to the xy. So ye to the xy is the derivative of this first term, the partial derivative of this first term with respect to x. Here of the second term, we know that's much simpler. It's just 2x. And then this term here, the y squared, is actually going to be 0, because if we plug in 3 for y, again, we're treating it as a constant, like 5 here. If we plug in 3, right, we'll get 9, which is still a constant, and the derivative of any constant is just 0. So we end up with 0 for this term. And then the other thing I did want to do before we moved on, this equation here, when you're doing linear approximation, what I should have done before I went through all of these steps was actually subtracted. If you can imagine, if you take this equation and you subtract 5 from both sides, right, this will become 0 equals, and then this whole thing, right, instead of equals 5, the 5 used to be over here, we subtracted it from both sides, and you end up with 0 on the other side. and negative 5 on this side. We want to do that because it's important that we at least acknowledge that the 5 is in here, and like I need to make sure that I'm dealing with the 5 when I'm taking partial derivatives. Of course, in this case, it's going to go away because it's a constant, and the derivative of any constant is 0, so it doesn't factor into this partial derivative. But you should always first subtract that constant from both sides and get this equal to 0. So let's go ahead and continue. This is the entire partial derivative with respect to x. So now let's go ahead and take the partial derivative with respect to y. Same as before, except now we're holding x constant. So in this case, if we hold x constant, we treat x as, let's call it the number 4. So pretend x is 4, right? E to the 4y, we're taking the derivative with respect to y when y is our variable. So the derivative of e to the 4y would be 4e to the 4y. So in this case, 4 represents x. So we're looking at x e to the xy for our derivative. Then we move on to x squared. The derivative of x squared with respect to y is 0. With respect to x, of course, it's 2x. But with respect to y, we're holding x constant. So this is treated like 4. 4 squared is 16, and 16 is a constant, so the derivative is 0. Of course, then this y squared, y is actually the variable we're dealing with here, so this becomes minus 2y. And then, of course, the 5 is still a constant, so the derivative there is 0. So these are the partial derivatives with respect to x and y. And now what we need to do is three things. We need to plug in our point to 0 to three different things: the original equation and both partial derivatives. So let's go ahead and plug it into our original equation first. So 2 is representing x here, obviously, and 0, y. So let's go ahead and say 0 equals e, let's see, x, so that's 2 times y, which is 0, plus x squared. So 2 squared minus y squared, y is 0, and then minus 5. Okay, so 2 times 0 is 0. So we end up with e to the 0 plus 4 minus 0 minus 5. E to the 0, in fact, anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So we end up with 1 plus 4 minus 5, which is 5 minus 5, which is 0. Okay, so when we plug in the point to the original equation, when we get our answer here, what we're solving for is z1 right here. So z1, let's just go ahead and write it above here, is going to be 0. 0 and 2 here for y and x are what we plug in for x1 and y1. So we plug in 2 for x1, and we plug in 0 for y1. You can imagine we're looking at points in a three-dimensional coordinate space, and we have a point in that space, x, y, z, and that point is 2, 0, 0. So when we plugged in this point here, we got an answer for z1. We solved for that third coordinate of the point, and so we plug in x, y, and then whatever we solved for, which is z1. So we plug in those things. Remember I said we're leaving alone x, y, and z. So the only things we have left to solve for are a and b. In this case, the way we find a and b, in fact in every linear approximation case, is we plug in the point 2, 0 to each of our partial derivatives here. So when I plug in 2, 0 to the partial derivative with respect to x, I get I plug in 0 for y, so e to the 2 times 0 plus 2 times 2. Okay, so this whole thing is multiplied by 0, so it just becomes 0, and then we have plus 4, So that's 4. And when we plug it in for x, it's called the slope in the x direction. But really, you just need to remember, right, if we're plugging in the point to the partial derivative with respect to x, naturally, it's going to be a, because a is grouped here with the x's. So we plug in 4 for a. And then when we solve, when we plug in the point 2, 0 to the partial derivative with respect to y, it'll be for b, because it's grouped here with the y's. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll have 2e to the 2 times 0 minus 2 times 0. Okay, so this is going to be e to the 0, which is 1. So we have 2 times 1 minus, and then this 2 times 0 here, of course, is just 0. I'm sorry, I'm working backwards, but so it's 2. We've got 2 times 1 minus 0. So 2 is the slope in the y direction, or b. So we've got 2. So now that we solve for all three of those things, all we need to do is simplify this linear approximation equation. So let's go ahead and write it out. We've got z minus 0, or I don't need to write minus 0, that just goes away. Z equals 4 times x minus 2 plus 2 times y. I don't need to write minus 0. I can just leave that. So now, you can leave it like this, it's acceptable, but it's a little cleaner to multiply things out and reorganize, so we'll end up with z equals 4x minus 8 plus 2y, and then you always want to do your variables in alphabetical order with your constants at the end. So the cleanest answer would be z equals 4x plus 2y minus 8, just moving that 8 there to the end with the variables up front. So that's linear approximation. Remember, subtract 5 from both sides to get this set equal to 0, take partial derivatives with respect to x and y, then go ahead and plug in the point that they give you to the original function to find z1, to the partial derivative with respect to x to find a, and to the partial derivative with respect to y to find b. Use your points here, 0 and 2, or 2 and 0, sorry, to represent x1 and y1, and then go ahead, plug everything in, simplify, and solve. So your final answer is z equals 4x plus 2y minus 8. See you guys next time.